it's with all of you. And I apologize, I have a bad cold. I've been coughing for the past week and a half, but I'll do my best. I would actually like to talk to you about mentoring in leadership through professional associations. This past year, I've been involved with mentoring. And also, over the years, I've been a mentor to several professionals who, just need a little bit of support and encouragement. And so that's why I decided to talk to you about this today. And in particular, I'd like to cover the importance of mentoring in leadership for women leaders and the affordances of a program that we have within TESO International Association that's called Leadership Mentoring Program. And I don't know if I can get the slides. There you go. So in terms of importance of mentoring and leadership for women leaders, I think we can really provide encouragement for new leaders in ELT. That's a really key piece. And also support for new and emerging leaders in ELT. Mentoring enables an experienced person one can count on to give advice and guidance. It's been really instrumental for me in my roles as a leader, and should be seen as mentoring as transformational leadership, which I'm going to cover in the next slide. Maybe one of you can help me. There you go. I think I can do it. No, you went too far. There you go. There are a couple of approaches to mentoring that we have studied. Actually, my mentor within TESO has been Leah Kamenstein. And we wrote a chapter about our relationship, our mentoring relationship. And we discussed these two approaches. And so the one-way directional approach to mentoring assumes that the more experienced professional fills the less experienced one with knowledge. And the second approach, mentoring, is really the one that we advocate in this chapter. Continue to our relationship with the mentor and the experience, which involves a spiral process, since both participants set goals, such goals, and set new and higher goals aimed at leader development. So those aspects are really important. So as I was saying, preference is given to TESOlers from underrepresented groups, and that includes women and those who demonstrate evidence of organization experience, service, and potential for involvement and leadership within the association. So it also provides individuals who are accepted into the LMP with basic registration to the annual convention, $1,000 for accommodation expenses during the relationship with a TESO leader, and waived participation in TESO's leadership development program, which is a paced online program that provides participants with up-to-date information about TESO. They learn the fundamentals of leadership and several other areas. So, that's why I decided to talk about, mentoring and leadership today, because of my participation in the leadership mentoring program with TESO. I participated as a mentee in 2005-2006, before I ran for the board of directors. Actually, I took on several leadership positions prior to being on the board, or running for the board, really. And as I mentioned, Leah Kamenstein was my mentor then. And I participated as a mentor myself in 2014-2015 to Ali Fuad Selvi, who is now on the convention, program council or committee, and he's going to be the convention program chair next year. which we're so excited about. And so the success of experience in the LMP, we have found is perhaps due to the fact that we chose each other as mentors and mentees prior to our participation in the program. And I feel that, you know, that's really important. When I applied for it, I was nominated actually by Leah, and I approached her and I said, could you be my mentor for the program? And she said yes. And so it was really nice. And I did the same with Alif Wad. I said, you know, I would like to nominate you for this program and I will serve as your mentor. So we just wrote a chapter for a book that Christine Coombe and her colleagues are editing. And we talk about the mentoring program there. And so the mentee becomes a mentor and the new mentor becomes a liaison between the original mentor and the new mentee. Sort of like me in kind of in the middle with Leah being my mentor and then me being Ali Fouad's mentor. So I think that this is what the program, you know, really allows us to do, and it's very exciting. But I wanted to talk a little bit more about specifically about mentoring and leadership for women. And it's really important to have a trusted person with whom to exchange ideas. So I know that other places also have mentoring programs. Marjorie is just saying that we mentor new trustees and SEEK coordinators as well in IATEFL. So it's really important. I don't know if you guys have you know, a leadership mentoring program like TESOL does, but it has been really instrumental. I cannot say enough about the program, and that's why I decided to talk about it today. Specifically, when I've worked with Leah, asking for advice on when to run for a leadership position has been really key. So, for example, before I got tenure, I wanted to run for the board, and she said, "No, you should not do that." And she said, "You need to get tenure first. Make sure you have that, because it is a lot of work being on the board of directors." And so she, you know, sharing of experiences has been really, really key for both of us, exchanging ideas. And also before I ran for president, you know, we also talked and she said, "You should make sure that you're a full professor before you run for president, because that is a lot of commitment and time and all of that." So even today, even though we are not more in this formal mentoring relationship, you know, we still talk to each other and ideas. And when I'm doing too much, she sends me a text message and she tells me, "Lou, you are doing too much. Make sure that you focus," and things like that. And those kinds of things, because you have a relationship, you know, those kinds of things are really important. And it emphasizes continuity. And I feel like, you know, we have a mentor for life in that sense. So I think that that's really important. And the bottom line for us, and as Alif Wad, myself, and Leah wrote, rather than treating mentoring as a linear transmission of a set of static ideas, general skills, and decontextualized practices, we conceptualize it as a creative, co-constructed, multifaceted, and lifelong process in which both the mentor and the mentee engage in bi-directional and transformational growth. Because it's true, both the mentor and the mentee really grow, you know, as people and as professionals. So that is really important. And I wanted to end with a few questions for reflection. You know, those of you who are using the chat boxes, maybe you can provide some answers there or continue the conversation at some point. What are some mentoring experiences you have had in your professional career? How did this mentoring relationships develop and evolve? considering these relationships, would you say some are more successful than others? And to what do you attribute their success? And if you haven't had many mentoring experiences, how would you go about developing them? And some of you are talking about, you know, retirees being mentors and things like that. And, you know, it's, I think that's really key as well. That's a great idea. So maybe you can, you know, think about and consider those questions for reflection. You know, in the chat box, we have about a minute left. So, and here are my references. I'm going to go ahead and turn on the camera again so you can see me at least for a little bit. So these are my references, and thank you very much for having me. And this is my contact information if you'd like to get in touch with me. And many of you will be in Chicago in a couple of weeks, so I will see you there.